Now, may I request the next speaker, Dr. G. T. Narasimhachar, to give his paper. Dr. G. T. Narasimhachar is a triple MA, MA in Sanskrit, MA in Kannada, and MA in Hindi. He has got three MAs and a PhD 1993, and his thesis is a literary study of Sanskrit inscriptions of Karnataka. He has got 30 years of teaching experience, and he has presented research papers in many conferences and seminars. He knows many languages, and he is propagating Dravida Veda also, because in the entire 1 month he chants the Dravida Veda for Tamil knowing people. That shows how he is a polyglot. He is not restricting himself to one or two languages. Let all languages come to me. Ano Bhadra Kratavoyanta Vishwato Dabdaso Aparita Savudbidaha. Rigvedic statement. With these few words, may I now request Dr. G.T. Narasimhachar to present his paper, please. Over to Dr. G.T.N.
Good morning to one and all. In one of the today's Kannada Daily, under the today's engagements, my paper is announced as Priya Purana. Instead of Periya Puranam, it is printed as Priya Purana. So it is a welcome mistake. So it is Priya also and Periya also. Yesterday, Sri Madhu Pandit Das spoke that we are standing under the feet of, under the lotus feet of Lord Krishna, because above there is sanctum sanctorum of Lord Krishna. So Krishna is a lord of dance, Navaneeta Natya Pandita. So also Lord Shiva is Natya Raja. So under the lotus feet of Lord Krishna, I am going to talk about Lord Nataraja, Lord Shiva. The Periya Puranam, sometimes called as Tiru Tondar Puranam, is a Tamil poetic account depicting the legendary lives, services and sayings of the 63 Nayanmars, the canonical poets of Tamil Shaivism. This paper is intended to present a few aspects of the book with a general perspective. The saints described here are historical personalities who lived between 5th and 10th centuries. There may be some controversy about this. Some scholars drag the lower limit even up to 1st century AD. They attained salvation by their staunch devotion to Shiva or to the servitors of Shiva. They belonged to different castes and occupations. There were kings, queens, merchants, potters, farmers, toddy tappers, and so on. Their common attribute was their unstinted devotion to Lord Shiva. The Periya Puranam was compiled in the 12th century by Shakyeda during the rule of Kulottunga Chola II, also called as Anapaya Chola. The date of the king is from 1133 to 1150, the period of his rule. The poet was born at Kunrathu in Tondai Mandalam. Actually, Shakyedar is the name of a family in Vellala community in which he was born. His first name was Arulmoli Devar. Due to his high learning and wisdom, he came to be called by his family name as Shakyedar. His extraordinary brilliance made him the chief minister of Anapaya Chola. A later saint, Umapati Shivacharya, has written a book reflecting the life of Shakyedar. Among all the hagiographic Puranas in Tamil, Shettiar's book stands first. About the title of the book. In the title Periya Purana, Periya means great. The book is great since it contains the stories of great saints. As the term Puranam is a part of the title of the book, it is appropriate to say something about this term. Puranas, along with Smritis and Itihasas, are generally considered as belonging to Mitra Samhita category of ancient literature, as against Vedas, which come under Prabhu Samhita. Samhita is equal to, so Mitra Samhita is equal to a friend, Prabhu Samhita equal to a lord. And Kavyas come under Kanta Samhita. The Vedic instruction is like a king's order or law. So they are called Prabhu Samhita. This strictness becomes less in Puranas, that is, historical narration and legends. Ancient Puranas are not like a scepter-wielding king. They are like familiar friends. They advise us by giving the instances of how people acted in the past and what were the results, whether good or bad. They present the topics logically and teach duties and prohibitions. This manner appeals to the minds of the people. Hence, people will take to the path of virtue because of reason, not because of fear. Hence, they are grouped under Mitra Samhita. Periya Puranam is a Mitra Samhita as it is a Purana, as well as a Kanta Samhita as it inherits the qualities of a classic poetry. The term Purana generally means old legend. The Vayu Purana says, Yasmat Purahi Anati Idam Puranam Tena Tat Smritam. Niruktasya asya yo veda, niruktam asya yo veda, sarva papaihi pramuchyate. Brahmanda Purana also observes, yasmat purahi abhuta chayetate, puranam tena tat smritam. Both of these statements almost mean Puranas as old legends. This meaning appears to fit well with the word Purana in the title Periya Purana. Thus, Periya Puranam means a great account of great Shaiva saints. The word Puranam is not found either in the Tamil Nighantu or in ancient Tamil texts. The very first reference to Puranam has been made in the Tiruvachakam of Manikkavachakar in 10th century. In this book, only the invocatory section consisting of about 95 lines has been named as Shiva Puranam. Periya Puranam is the first Tamil Puranam in whole. In later period, some other books called as Purana were written, among them Thiruvilayadal Puranam of Paranjothi Munivar, also known as Sokkanatha Swami, Kanda Puranam of Kachiyappa Shivacharya, Thirumurai Kanda Puranam of Umapati Shivacharya are notable. The source and inspiration for the Periya Purana. Any great book cannot be produced by an ordinary man and in ordinary context. Similarly, there is an interesting story behind the production of Periya Purana also. The author Shettiar was the chief minister in the court of the Chola king, Kulothunga Chola II. The king was a staunch devotee of Lord Shiva, particularly of Lord Nataraja of Chidambaram. In those days, Jainism in Tamil Nadu was not very strong, but still the Jain literature in Tamil was capable of changing the religious attitude of persons. This is what happened in the life of the Chola king also. As a matter of fact, the 5 chief epic poems in Tamil, grouped as Aimberam Kavyam, as we have Panchamaha Kavya in Sanskrit literature, in Tamil literature also, 5 Kavyas are grouped as Aimberam Kavyam, are all written, all these 5 Karyas in Tamil are written either by a Buddhist or by a China poet. the book Jivaka Chintamani of the Jain poet Tiruttakka Deva is one such poem which played a role in the life of the king Kulothunga Chola. Jivaka Chintamani is a Tamil Kavya. The king was enchanted by the story of the hero Jivaka depicted in the poem. In the story, the hero Jivaka marries many damsels and regains kingship over his father's lost kingdom. In the end, he realizes the temporary nature of positions, renounces kingship, and finally attains nirvana by prolonged austerity. This story impressed the Chola king so much that he became inclined towards Jainism. The poet minister Shakyala wanted to bring back the king on the path of Shaivism. He advised the king to abandon the pursuit of erotic literature and turn instead to the life of the Shaiva saints. This advice was taken positively by the king. He suggested Shakyala to describe the lives of the Shaiva saints in an epic poem. The poet also thought that the mind changed by a literary mean can be reverted only by another better epic poem. This thought made the poet to write a book on Shaiva saints, containing absolute devotion of Shiva on Shiva only and nothing else. In this context, we have to mention one more source of inspiration for the poet Shakyala, that is the Jain book Mahapurana, written by Acharya Janasena in Sanskrit and completed by his pupil Gunabhadra. Shakyala wanted to write a Puranam in Tamil on the lines of above mentioned poem Mahapurana. The Sanskrit book presents the stories of 63 great men in Jainism, called as Trishashti Sharaka Purusha. Incidentally, Shaivism also had in its treasure of heritage 63 great saints. Look at the similarity: 63 Sharaka Purushas in Jainism and 63 Nayanmars in Shaivism also. 63 great saints, their life story and songs for its support. This struck the mind of the poet. What more? He decided to write a book on the life of 63 Nayanmars. Not only that, Shakyala used this opportunity to establish superiority of Shaivism over Jainism at some places of his book. The literary material necessary to write such a book was already available to Shakyala in the form of Tirumurais. Tirumurai means holy divisions of canonical books. Such books are 12 in number, which include the Periya Puranam also. Sundaramurti Nayanar in the 9th century had initiated the valuable service of preserving the Shaiva songs of the great saints Appar and Sambandhar in Tamil. He had preserved those songs in his book called Tiruttondar Thohai and included his own songs also in the said book. But the book was in oblivion until the Rajaraja Chola discovered the collection in the temple of Chidambaram. At the king's advice, the scholar Nambi Andar Nambi during the 11th century re-edited the collection of Sundarar and compiled the first 7 volumes which contained the songs of the trio Appar, Sambandhar and Sundar. 8th one is the composition of Manikya Vachakar. 9th one is a collection of songs of about 8 saints. The Tirumandiram of the famous Siddhar Tirumular forms the 10th book. 11th book contains the songs and life of the rest of the saints. Then the Periya Puranam also became a part of the sacred canon as the 12th Tirumurai. These 12 Tirumurais, along with Vedas and Shaiva Agamas, form the basis of Shaiva Siddhanta in Tamil Nadu. The poet has taken into consideration even the inscriptions of his time and also Sthala Puranas that were in vogue. He should have travelled to birthplaces of the Nayanmars and to the holy places visited by them and should have got first-hand experience of the silk beauty of the places and should have collected information about the signs from the elderly people. He has made use of these data in his book. He pays special tribute to Sambandhar or Nambi Arora for his academic service in preserving the Thevaram songs in the book Tiruthondar Thohai. Glory of the Periya Puranam is as follows. God's grace was also showered on the poet Shakir R. as Lord Shiva himself provided the first foot of the poem. The first line of the poem was pronounced by Lord Shiva himself. The book commences with the first foot of the first verse. Ulahelam unarndu odarkariyavan, which is said to be the divine voice reproduced by the poet. Shakir R. poetic power earned him the title Uttama Chola Pulavar. Later, he was glorified to such an extent that he was also reckoned as a Nayanmar. Shakir R. himself was also counted as a Nayanmar, raising the list of Nayanmars to 64 from the earlier 63. At some temples, his idol was also installed beside those of 63 popular saints. Further, a temple exclusively for Shakir R. and his patron kin Anapaya Chola was built in Kundrathu, the birthplace of the farmer. Though there were earlier hagiographies of the Shaiva saints, Periya Puranam occupied a special place in Tamil literature of Chola period because of its highest order of the literary style. It is considered as one of the masterpieces of the Tamil literature. The poet Shakir R., however, names his book as Thondara Puranam, Tiruthondara Puranam. He himself names it as Tiruthondara Puranam. Engidan Namam Koorin, Shindayul Sharndu Nindra, Pongiya Irula Yenai, Pura Irul Pokku Hindra, Shangadiravan Pol Nikkum Tiruthondara Puranam, Enbaam. It was named Periya Puranam by the later writer Umapati Shivacharya, who wrote a book called Shakir Nayanar Purana. He himself became a subject for a work of Purana in the later period, glorifying Shakir in 13th century. In the later period, the name Periya Puranam itself became popular than the name given by the poet. The name Tiruthunda Puranam went to backside and Periya Puranam became famous. The title Periya Puranam became famous. Periya Puranam book is divided into two broad sections called Kanda. Each Kanda is divided into cantos called Charukam, which is Sarga in Tamil Sanskrit books. The same is pronounced as Charukam in Tamil literature. Totally, there are 13 cantos from two sections. Total number of verses is 4,286. About Sundarar, a special mentioning is to be made here. Though there are 63 signs dealt with in the book, the poet seems to give more importance to Alala Sundarar, also known as Nambi Arora. This particular saint is described as the greatest devotee of Lord Shiva in Kailasa. The first canto, Tirumalai Charukam, describes him as having descended from Kailasa to uplift the world and to free it from sins. Vediyar kolathul, Vediyar kulathul thonri, Teethahandu ulaham uya Tiru avataram shaydar. That is the statement about the descent of Sundarar to the earth. He lived for a very short period of 18 years, only 18 years. The last canto, Vellanai Churukam, last canto of the book Tiruthondar Puranam, that is named as Vellani Charukam. This section describes his ascension to Kailasa after doing his service to the mankind. Besides, his association with other two Nayanmars, namely Earkon Kalikamar and Kadalattarivar Nayanar, are brought out in the middle of the work. One is in 6th canto, the other one is in 7th canto. Thus, Sundarar is present in the beginning, in the middle, and in the end of the book. Surprisingly, He has a lesser number of songs sung by him compared to Appa and Sambandha. The birthplace of Sundarar is described in detail than any other saint. About 1/5 of the verses he devoted to sketch the life of Sundarar in detail. He lived on the earth for only 18 years, but a marvelous life indeed. Shakyamuni gratefully acknowledges, both in the beginning and in the end, for having the book of Sundarar entitled Tiruthondar Thohai as a source for his book. All these points justify that Nambi Arurar or Sundaramurti Nayanar has been offered a special reverence by the poet. The essence of this book is devotion, bhakti rasa. So pure love or devotion to the God, and also devotion and tolerance towards the servants of the Lord, is the chief qualification needed for seeker of salvation. It must be total love. It must be total love. Such love allows anyone to the realm of mukti, irrespective of birth in any caste. The saints dealt with in Periyapuranam did their occupations not only as a means of livelihood, but also as a means of service to the God and also to the servants of the God. For example, the potter, Tirunilakantha, Koyavanar. There are two Tirunilakanthas coming in this Nayanmar's list. One is a potter, Tirunilakantha. Another one is Tirunilakantha Yalpandar, who is a singer, a musician. So Tirunilakantha Koyavanar, the potter, besides making pots and pans, he made alms bowls also to the devotees. Some saints visualized Shiva by rendering services in the temple premises other than worship of the lingam in the temple. Vedic culture is upheld throughout the book. The poet Shakyamuni upholds the importance of Vedas and Vedic culture through the life sketch of the saints. Hundreds of such references are available throughout the text. In Tirujnana Sambandha's chronicle, the God bestowed upon Shivapada Hridayar a son who would destroy alien religions and re-establish Vedic religion. Veda is extolled in many times in the book. To mention a few, Marai is text with hidden meaning. Then Mamarai, great Vedas. Menmai Nanmarai, noble Vedas, and Andanar Arumarai, sacred Vedas of the Brahmins, Tumarai, pure Vedas, Mundai Marai, ancient Vedas, Maimori, truthful text, and so on. Elsewhere, Vedas are described as Yadudada Marai. It is only Shruti, you know. So Yadudada Marai, meaning sacred text not committed to writing, and Yellayillada Marai, endless Vedas. Shiva is called Veda Karanar. Lord Shiva himself is called as Veda Karanar, one who created Vedas, and also Vedian, Marayavan, and Veda Navan. Sambandhar was born for the full growth of the Vedic tradition with all its branches. Veda Neri Tadaitu Onga. Veda Neri Tadaitu Onga. That is the purpose of the birth of Sir Sambandhar. In the description of villages, the poet draws heavily from the Vedic tradition. Even nature is described as filled with Vedic sounds and sacrifices. The poet comes with full faith while giving such statements. Then asceticism. The asceticism described in the Periyapuranam does not take external signs into consideration. It does not need renunciation of the family. One need not renounce the family or homes and occupations. Ascetics depicted here renounced their, what did they renounce? They renounced their evil feelings like anger, passion, pride, desire, attachment to pleasures and the like. They were far away from the evil conducts like theft, hurting others and so on. They practiced non-violence, truthfulness and austerity. They were ascetics in thought, speech and action. Shakyamuni gives the caricature of these ascetics as follows. Peramayal Tamme Oppar, Penal Emme Petra, Uramayal Ulahe Velvar, Unamayal Unnum Yella, Arumayam Nilayal Nindra, அந்தினால் இன்பம் ஆர்வார் இருமையும் கடந்து நின்று இவரை நீ அடைவா என்று தி சர்வன்ஸ் ஆஃப் காட் ஆர் கிரேட் கம்பேரபிள் ஓன்லி டு தெம்செல்ஸ் பை ஷியர் சர்வீஸ் தே வின் ஓவர் அஸ் தே ஆர் கேபபிள் ஆஃப் வின்னிங் தி வேர்ல்ட் வித் தேர் யுனிக்னெஸ் தே ஆர் ஹார்ம்லெஸ் தே அட்டைன் இம்பாசிபிள் ஸ்டேட்டஸ் இன் லைஃப் தே சீக் ஹாப்பினஸ் த்ரூ தே They seek happiness through for others. They have got rid of the influence of spiritual ignorance. May you follow them and get their grace. Sanatana Dharma is not restricted to any caste or province or to any language or creed. It is universal. Anyone can follow this Dharma. Shakyamuni gives an open invitation in the end to all the people of the world to join the association of devotees. Those who belong to other provinces ruled by kings of Chola, Chera and Pandya, outside Tamil-speaking regions, can also become servants of the God by seeking shelter at the feet of Lord Shiva. The poet includes such people under the category Appalum Adisharndar. There is a separate section itself, Appalum Adisharndar, to announce this poetic appreciation of the book. The poet has proved his poetic ability by showing excellences by descriptions and delineation of rasa. He has made best of opportunities he got to show his poetic talent also. May it be description of a place or mountain or green field or river, the poet presents new idea. River Kaveri is described at several places with great native spirit and love. For example, the subsection Thirunattu Chirap of the first canto, Thirumalai Churukkum, describes the river as follows. The river Kaveri is described in these lines. At many places it is available. For example, reproducing a verse. Malin undi chuli malaratan mel varum shal binal palluyir tarum tan man binal kolandar kundikai thanke kolgayal kolum nanmuganiyam ponnimanadi. Here the Kaveri is described as equal to Brahma himself. The river emerges from the flowery origin as even Brahma originates from the flower emerging from the navel of Lord Vishnu. Both the river and Brahma create and sustain many living beings. Thus the river Kaveri also does the same thing. Thus Kaveri and Brahma both create and sustain many living beings. In the same subsection, the river is equated with the river Ganga. The description goes thus. Kaveri originates from the mountain in Talakaveri. The moon shines beautifully on the top of the mountain. So the top of the mountain appears like the head of Shiva himself, adorned with the digit of the moon. How can the moon be without Ganga? So river Kaveri is like the river Ganga on the lofty head of Lord Shiva. The verse goes like this. Thingal shoodiya mudi chigarattu uchchiyal Pongu ventalai nurai porudu kodalal Engal nayagan mudimuchan inreyili Gangayam, Punyam, Kanninittami. Look at the fertility of the Kaveri basin. The crop grown here are extraordinary. On seeing a tall grown crop, you may take it to be sugarcane. It is not sugarcane, but it is paddy crop. At some other place, you may mistake sugarcane to be arecanut tree. Karumballa nellenna, kamukalla karumbenna. This is the magic played by the river Kaveri and its soil. The hard work of the farmers with their family, their simple life, their joy at the time of harvest are all described graphically by the poet. Lastly, I would like to mention a few things about influence of this Periya Puranam on the Kannada poet Harihara. Periya Puranam in Kannada literature. A literary work of a genius generally casts influence on the later literature. In this process, the contents of the original book transgresses all barriers of languages, castes and provinces. The literary merit of the book becomes more important. The glory of the Periya Puranam is such that it has also influenced poets of other languages. Particularly the poet Kannada poet, the popular Kannada poet Harihara is inspired very much by Periya Puranam. The Kannada scholars D.L. Narasimhachar and Mr. Srinivasamurthy, M.R. Srinivasamurthy, are of the opinion that Harihara had a good knowledge of the Periya Puranam of Shikyadar. Harihara has written poems on almost all the INMRs described by Shekira. A comparison of the two texts show striking similarity of thoughts and expressions at many places. I would like to show only a couple of instances here. In the narration of the story of Tirunilakantha, the Perepuranam presents a situation as follows. இளமையின் மிக்குளார்கள் இருவரும் அறிய நின்றார். அளவில் சீர் ஆணை போற்றி ஆண்டுகள் பலவும் செல்ல வழமறி இழமை நீங்கி வடிவுறு மூப்பு வந்து தளர்வொடு சாய்ந்து அன்பு தம்பிரான் கிரத்து சாயாழன். திருநீலகண்டர் அண்ட் இஸ் சேஸ்ட் வைஃப் போத் ஹேட் ஸ்வோர்ன் ஆன் சம் அகேஷன் தட் தே வுட் நாட் டச் ஈச் அதர். ஆஸ் இயர்ஸ் ரோல்டு தேர் யூத் ஃபேடட், தே பிகேம் ஓல்டு, தேர் பாடிஸ் பிகேம் வீக், but their love for Shiva was not weak. The same situation is described by Harihara in the following words. Nambi palakelavu vatsara varjisuttamire aane pakvatya bandante bandudu muppu Shiva bhakti sopanadante teregalu masake Shiva nalla daru illambante tale naduge. Aandugal palavum shella in Piriya Puranam is expressed in Kannada as palakelavu vatsara varjisuttamire. அளவில் ஆணை போற்றி இன் தமிழ் ஹேஸ் பிகம் ஆணை பக்குவக்க பந்தந்தே இன் கன்னடா. மூப்பு வந்து இஸ் ரிஃப்ளெக்டட் பை பந்துது மூப்பு. ஐ திங்க் திஸ் சிங்கிள் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இஸ் சஃபிஷியன்ட் டு ஷோ ஹவு ஹரிஹரா ஹஸ் பாரோட் இஸ் ஐடியாஸ். ஸோ இன் தி கன்க்ளூஷன், இன் மை கன்க்ளூஷன் யூ கேன் சே தி பெரிய புராணம் பீங் எ கனானிக்கல் லிட்ரேச்சர் இன்ஹெரிட்ஸ் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஏ பியூட்டிஃபுல் போயிட்ரி ஆல்சோ. So, readers of different tastes are sure to enjoy the charm of the poetry and get benefited spiritually also by cherishing the sentiment of devotion, knowingly or unknowingly. The important messages given by Periya Puranam are: the religion established in Vedas is universal in nature. The God is not partial to any caste or creed or any social grade. In the world of devotion, all are equal. Mukti is open to all. Only the things required to obtain mukti are study, bhakti in the Supreme Almighty, and love for the creatures. Of course, pure mind, good character, and conduct are means to develop such love. Thanks for the patient hearing. Thank you.
Well, so far we have heard a very nice narration of Periya Puranam, wherein Dr. G.T. Narasimhachar, with his triple MA, concentrated on triple topics: Jaina Purana in Tamil literature, along with Shalaka Purushas, that is one point. Periya Purana and Shalaka Purushas, comparison between Jaina Purana and Tamil Purana. Second point is he concentrated on influence of Periya Puranam on Kannada literature with special reference to Harihara. And he talked about the concepts of Bhakti and Veda, how exactly they are interconnected with one another. Bhakti hi kinna karotyaho bhagavato bhaktava tamsayate. What not bhakti can culminate for a devotee from the point of view of Shankara's Shivananda Lahari. How exactly Vedic culture is to be upholded and propounded, he nicely delivered with the example of giving various shades of meaning which Periya Puranam extends for Vedas, like hidden meaning, noble meaning, sweet text, pure text, truthful text, endless text, and so on and so forth. And lecture on Periya Puranam is also endless, and unfortunately it had to be ended. Kalaya Tasmai Namaha. With these few words, may I now request Sri C.N. Ashok Kumar, Deputy Director, Bharati Vidya Bhavan, Bengaluru, to kindly honor Dr. G.T. Narasimhachar for his excellent presentation on Periya Puranam. we crave the indulgence of the speaker because we did not give him sufficient time to give the total lecture. Anyway, that will be printed when it gets into the book form. We will assure you that all these articles will be printed in the form of a book wherein you will have the feast of knowledge when it comes out.